Cochran, the survivor nerd.
Eighth person voted out of Survivor South Pacific.
He betrayed his tribe.
He threw the whole tribe under the bus. You disgust me.
And paid the ultimate price. And he took Dawn down with him.
I want to take control for the first time.
He told her his plan to flip.
Dawn.
But she was too loyal to go along.
It's hot right now, right? I know.
It's really hot.
I just want to make sure. I only ask because I want to make sure it's not because I'm like feverishly.
No, it's hot. It's really hot.
Weather-wise, this is not my environment. I was not aware how quickly I could become sunburned. The sun is constantly roasting you. My entire body, head to toe, literally my toes are sunburned.
Oh my gosh! What's
happening? He's so swollen.
Look at
his feet.
They're swollen.
Oh man, that's bad.
It does feel very, very tight. Yeah, I guess it is really swollen.
You need to elevate them.
Cochran is like a little tomato right now. He is all bright red all over the place, and he's swollen, like a little pregnant lady.
I can't do anything.
That's what we did last
time. I'm burning. When I move, I get exhausted. If we had a challenge right now, I'd actually die. Yeah. Trying to put on a brave face, maybe make some self-deprecating comments around camp, like, oh yeah, I look like a lobster, I look like a freak, haha, it's funny. I'm actually in horrible pain right now. And I feel like crying, kind of, but I'm, you know, trying to stay strong. I mean, my new persona is strong, a little bit of swagger, a little more confidence. I can't be the same freak I was last time.
You know, back at home, I'm waiting the whole week long for Wednesday night at 8 to arrive so I can turn on CBS and see what's in store.
I just sit in the magical seat today.
Yeah, get to sit in the seat. I could crown you.
But when you're playing this game, every single day is like Wednesday night at 8. It's wild, and that's what I love. I get to watch Survivor while I'm playing Survivor, and for a Survivor nut like I am, this is a dream come true.
This is great. I don't know why I don't know why, like, in the rest of the world people don't do this.
Because they're not the specialists.
The weird thing is that it's not normal for me to be surrounded by all these beautiful women who are half the time just wearing their underwear. I mean, that's some sort of Freudian picnic, I think. But it's real here.
It's a good thing that there's...
Eddie was worried that this might damage his dating prospects. He's going to be viewed as someone that's partaken in something very gross and, you know, potentially alienating women. For me, you know, I need some sort of image rehabilitation. I think this would add a little bit of a wild streak to me and might make me seem a little bit more dangerous. I think this is exactly what my love life needs.
Cochran! Law! Pulls it out for immunity!
Wow.
Good job, guys.
Good job. Now,
Cochran, come on over.
I've been waiting my whole life for this. You're going to touch my shoulders. It's going to be incredible.
Cochran, safe at tonight's tribal council.
Hold it, Eddie.
He cannot! Eddie's out! Cochran wins immunity!
I am the greatest challenge competitor in Survivor Caramel. There's no debate. If you look at the scoreboard, I'm demolishing everybody. I won half the individual immunity challenges. I'm the guy that was screamed at after every challenge last time I played because I'm such a freaking liability, because I suck in challenges, because I'm weak.
The advantage is big.
But now I am the biggest challenge threat in this game. And I don't care if it makes me a threat. I'm just going to keep winning.
Cochran, the Survivor nerd, has transformed into an all-around threat. Eddie's out! Cochran wins immunity! Cochran pulls it out! Will he continue to dominate challenges and the game?
I've been watching Survivor with my parents for 13 years. I need to win this game, and I'm willing to go to any length to snatch that title.
Coming down to his last piece! Cochran wins!
Oh my gosh!
Final immunity! Is guaranteed a spot at the final tribal council!
Oh, earned that.
Hasn't lost its novelty yet, Jeff. Do it.
It's crazy!
Cochran with his third individual immunity win, fourth individual challenge win. You are in a very elite group right now.
I told you I should be among the Donaldsons and Marianas of the world, and now I'm doing it, right?
So this goes back to day one, the first time you played, when you said, please call me Cochran.
Yeah, I mean, I thought I proved myself last time, but I wasn't aware of what I could prove until I played this time around.
You are guaranteed a spot at the final tribal council. you will get a chance to plead your case for $1 million and why you deserve the title of sole survivor. Congrats.
Thank you.
Hi, Cochran. Have won 4 individual challenges. So right now I'm thinking, okay, I got the million. You know, the big question now is who deserves $100,000 in second place?
How are you feeling?
I don't think it's fully set in yet. I mean, you know, this is 13 years.
I know. Believe me, I know.
Yeah. It's not going to be Sherry. Sherry might be able to squeak out one vote, but she's not going to get enough to get second place. So now it's about, do I want to bring Dawn with her constant emotional outbursts, or Eddie, a chauvinistic 23-year-old idiot?
Pretty cool.
It was just like an epic Survivor day.
Yeah.
The battle for second place is a really heated one. I can't wait to see what happens. It's so lonely at the top. This is horrible stuff for me to be saying, but I, of course, lose. The first time in 39 days I've really felt frazzled is today. I've written a prize-winning paper at Harvard Law School on the Survivor jury system. There's a big difference between writing a paper and living out the reality, and I'm grappling with that dichotomy right now. Law school hasn't prepared me for this. You'd think it would. Sorry, Harvard, you haven't really taught me that much about how to address a jury. But I'm going to learn my lesson tonight, I think. Whenever things are looking good for me, I suddenly start expecting the worst and preparing myself for the worst. Am I going to be able to get on to Survivor, which I've been dreaming of doing for half my life? No, I'm a loser. They're never going to want somebody like me. And I get on, I get to return as a favorite. And, you know, this endgame scenario is no different. I feel like I've played a great game. I've gotten to the end. This is my game to lose. But all of a sudden, these doubts are plaguing my mind. I'm just kind of this awkward geek who hasn't really done anything. I know I've done stuff, and I know I can express myself, but this doubt just creeps in, or seeps in. And it's not healthy, especially when I have to be pleading my case and showing that I'm confident in the game I've played. But when I'm not feeling confident in myself, it's hard to do.
Cochran, opening statement.
So I'm also very nervous, but, you know, this is the culmination of 13 years of passion for Survivor. Half my life. In high school, I used to wear a buff every night that Survivor was on. I used to pass out a newsletter. I wrote a paper about it in law school. This is an obsession. And the fact that I'm here now is surreal and an honor. I had no fantasy that I would become one of the top 10 challenge performers in Survivor history. Socially, I consider myself a socially awkward person. I have anxiety, but somehow I kind of fell into the role of like therapist. You know, when paranoia was rampant around camp, I would step in and try to be a calming force, which is unusual for me. And strategically, I'm proud of myself. And when the merge hit, that's when the individual threats emerge. And I've seen every season of Survivor. I've never seen a collection of threats like this. And I know I can't out-muscle. I know I can't out-charm. I don't even think I can really out-strategize anybody, but I can beat people in timing. And that's what this game has been for me, is timing. Whenever a threat emerged, I would strike before I could be struck at. I've lied along the way. I've deceived along the way. And I'm proud of it, and I want to own it, and I want you to be aware why I think I played the best game here. So I'm looking forward to the questions. You can tear me apart, but I want to prove why I played the best game.
The winner of Survivor Fans...